over, grind game over, time's up. Play my cards, dumb, my hand ain't really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't, lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back, did what I could, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag, copy and paste with the swag. Bet you can't do it like me, all my winners on repeat. Take your L like a boss, standing tall.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay. No team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay. And this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Arizona Cardinals. On the return, here's Edmonds. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20.
At their own 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now Murray. He'll set up the screen to Drake. And he'll lose yardage here. Back to the 15. It's a loss of 4 on that first play, and it's second down.
You know what the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
But you're going to tell me, good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first is good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
The first defensive back taken in this year's draft, Darnell Savage, there to knock that one away. 14. Well, certainly not the start they were looking for here as they come up on a 3rd and 14. To throw is Murray, rolling to his left. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And finally, he goes out of bounds right at the 35-yard line. It's a big play on third down for the Cardinals. And even 50 yards. So that changes things a bit. Here's a 1st and 10 all the way down at the 35. Murray to air it out again. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Will Redmond. He's got daylight, the 20. And into the end zone, it's a pick six and a Packer touchdown. Those free safeties, they get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for six.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays, just as what we saw. A free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
Crosby with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
At their own 17-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and...
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Cardinals. Kenyon Drake, 83 yards. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. The CD, I mean, there are touchdown runs, and then there are touchdown runs. And that one certainly fell into the latter category. Now that deserves a couple exclamation points. Boy, tie game, first quarter, but still they're going to go with the onside kick. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. The Cardinals say they have it. They do. Arizona recovers. I can't say that's something you see often, but it worked out for them. Tie game, they try to get the ball back, and they do.
You know, when I was a kid, my dad used to give me a lot of tales about... This guy called Old Mo. I never knew who Old Mo was. Now I do. It's old momentum, and they want to keep riding it.
Oh, no. Is that a true story?
True story.
I love your pops. He's got a first down and then some at midfield.
You thought you had
it. He'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Kenyon Drake with his second touchdown of this opening quarter. And the Cardinals have taken the lead.
So that run there, yeah, I don't know if it's overstating things to call it a thing of beauty, but in terms of football plays, that's as good as you're going to see.
Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT, and that makes the score 14-7.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
Rodgers will break the huddle and bring the pack up first and 10 at their own 24.
He'll throw from the gun.
Looking deep for Adams. Oh, wide open, complete.
Here we go.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams, 76 yards. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying this thing up.
For as big and strong as some of these guys are, especially when you see them in full pads, it is sometimes hard to appreciate how truly fast they can move. That was incredible.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are. Throwing again on second down. Murray. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
17 yards. And the Cardinal first down.
Gun. Here's Murray. And his throw is incomplete. The tight end, Max Williams, the intended receiver. And now it's second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Steps away. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Drake. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 44-yard line. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs. So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. Running from the shotgun with Drake. And he's going to be stopped at about the 37. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three.
A 7-yard pickup brings up second and three.
From the gun, Murray dancing to his left. And he's going to lose a yard or two, taken down behind the line.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
These two teams all tied after one.
14-14.
From the gun on third down, Murray. And this one caught by Max Williams. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down. He needed five. He got it barely, as it will officially go down as a gain of 5 yards. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Operating from the gun, Murray. Caught left side, Williams. And he's going to get 7 out of this before being taken down at the 27. Murray going to run play action with Drake and look to throw it. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
Here comes play number 9 now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. They hand off to their big tight end. Oh, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. He needed 3. He got 2. Now that will set up an interesting situation here on 4th and a yard. And he's going to get the first down as they bring him down at the 23. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that. But by about the width of a shoelace, they convert on 4th down. Down, Drake. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
That's a strong pickup right there on 1st down, and as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's 2nd and a yard. Murray to give. This is Drake. He's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. That play gets him 6 yards and sets them up with a 1st and goal.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? 2nd and short, and they brought out that heavy package. Almost like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy 1st down conversion. A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have 1st half highlights and analysis from a back and forth 1st half that we've seen. And he is out of bounds here. Nice gain of 8 that time, but it's 2nd and goal. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Call it no gain that time, and now it's 3rd and goal. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. That'll bring up 4th. They had the 8-yard gain on 1st down, but unable to do much from there. And that is going to be incomplete. They're turned away on 4th and goal. And the Packer defense stands tall down by the goal line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. 1-play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. 1-play.
Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get there. He's at the 30. Past the 20. Touchdown, Packers. Devontae Adams. 98 yards, and the Packers are able to strike quickly for 6.
I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards. So just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14.
Mason Crosby, the kickoff for Green Bay.
touchdown. Here's Crosby to kick it away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. Driving at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do and the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
On play action, it's Murray. Packer pressure, and down he goes. There's a Darius Smith there getting in and bringing him to the ground. Well, it was second long, now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Well, that last sack puts Murray and the Cards in a tough spot. Third and long. From the gun, Murray. And he's got the completion to Hopkins. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half.
First down.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Murray now to throw. They'll roll him out right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. And that's caught inside the 30. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as it comes with 22 seconds to go here in half number one. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Operating from the gun, Murray. He's going to let it go deep for the end zone. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Larry Fitzgerald. As the first half is winding down, and the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. And he's got it up and through.
Ties the game at 21 apiece. Zane Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
A couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. Taken in at the 3. And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Final 12 seconds of the half now as they've got it first and 10. Shotgun now for Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. He rifles one that's intercepted. Jalen Thompson picks it.
Rodgers pass. Intercepted by the Cardinals.
That's how you get fouled.
They'll take over first down 10 at the 41-yard line.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. A final shot before half for Murray. Airs it out toward the corner of the end zone. And Hopkins has got it. Touchdown, Arizona. DeAndre Hopkins. As time expires in the first half. And the Cardinals have broken the tie. So now with a late touchdown, not only will they take the lead to the locker room, but they'll try and add two more here. They're going to keep it on the ground. But he will not get the 2 points. He stopped up short, and that is how this first half will come to an end. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we send you to our EA studios in Orlando. Here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. These offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? A gutsy call there. Yeggs at the locker room with a lead, tried the onside kick. It didn't work.
And you just wonder what the gain was there. They're already in the lead. They were in control of the game. They may have given momentum now to their opponent and maybe kickstarted things going in the opposite direction.
Rodgers now on first down. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line. Credit the sack there to Chandler Jones. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Throw's going to be incomplete. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver. But now it's third down.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
And he is going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. How about that? They weather the storm of a third and 17 to pick up the first. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now the man from UTEP, this is Aaron Jones. And he'll get a little over two, maybe a full three down to the 32-yard line. Throwing on second and 8, Rodgers. That is caught at the 7. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Mercedes Lewis, 32 yards. And the Packers have drawn even here with the extra point to come. And his kick is good.
Makes the score, Packers 28.
Touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And he'll be brought down at the 28-yard line, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone gets him three more.
Don't give him nothing! Don't give him nothing!
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And some room to run now. And into the end zone. It's a pick six. Well, you don't want to coach him, Charles, to stay in the pocket on every play, but I guess that's the danger of getting outside of the pocket, extending a play, and making a bad throw. Turns into 6 points the other way.
Yeah, sometimes when you get outside the pocket, your vision actually gets obscured a little bit, or you narrow it down too much, and you don't see all the defenders in the area.
Crosby connects on the extra point, and the lead is up to 8. And now the kick is away. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And fresh off the pick six, they've got to forget about that quickly.
In this case now, the guy throwing the ball.
And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down.
How many times have we sat with coordinators, and especially the defensive guys, that talked about big plays, sacks, they often come in bunches. Well, it may not be a bunch here, but that is the third sack of the game for them.
And around sack three or four, I would think, it starts to get in the quarterback's head a little bit.
Not just the quarterback, the offensive play caller, the offensive line, knocks people off balance and changes what they normally do.
It's just a gain of a couple there on the scramble, and now it's third down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
And that is incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
The offense going to stay out there. They've converted once, failed once. What can they do here on fourth down? They do go for it. It's Murray. Incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. It's caught inside the five. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Goal at the 2 yard line.
They'll try and run it in with Jones. And he's going to get this back to the 3 yard line and no further. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal.
Leads to second and goal at the 3.
And he's got it. It's caught for a Packers touchdown.
Let's go, boys. Let's go.
It's Devontae Adams hauling it in from Aaron Rodgers. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further.
And this is obviously quite a performance. And most of the time when we talk about someone putting a team on their back, I think we're talking about a guy who runs the football. In this case, it's a guy out wide catching it, and he's done exactly that, truly leading his team right now towards victory.
Three touchdown catches. He's been the headliner. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return.
At their own 31-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And this shot downfield on second down is brought in. And he finally goes down at the 23-yard line. A huge play there for Arizona. 44 yards.
27.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. From the gun. Murray steps away to his left, and now he's going to use his legs. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it, and he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. An 8-yard touchdown run. And the Cardinals get a bit closer. Not the first time on this drive we saw him take matters into his own hands, and this time he finishes things off with a touchdown run.
You're not going to be happy with me, but I think he took matters into his own feet, didn't he?
Oh, Davis from the top rope. I like it. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And able to get this out to the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
A about set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one possession game, down 8. They'll be looking for the touchdown and 2-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage.
A big play there, 38 yards.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. They'll run with Drake. And a pickup of about 4 down inside the 10 to the 8-yard line.
That was a particularly nice play because not only was it his job to force the play inside, he was actually able to fold inside himself and make the tackle ultimately. Very nicely done.
To throw on 2nd and 6, Murray. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's 3rd down.
And it's 3rd down.
Operating from the gun, Murray. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Dan Arnold there to make the grab. And now the Cardinals are within a 2-point conversion of tying up this game. Sometimes those tight ends are a mismatch. They found the mismatch there.
And that's exactly why you want to drop those types of plays, because coverage is just going to go to the natural guys, the guys that make the big plays on the outside. But you work your tight end into it, that's a tough one for a defense to handle.
Tough. They couldn't handle it. They worked out for 6. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. Fielded just outside the goal line. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. Past midfield, look out. Tyler Irvin on the loose. And he'll bring it back all the way. This game wasn't tied for long. How about that? A big return here in the fourth.
And this is that time of game where every big play is magnified. Fourth quarter, kick return for a touchdown. You've got to feel great about your chances at this stage of the game.
Yeah, they regain the lead. Now we'll see if they can hold it.
Mason Crosby to kick off for Green Bay.
So now the other return teams out there, as they'll try to duplicate what they just saw. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. And he is out of bounds here on the return.
At their own 25-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch counter punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got to a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. They'll run on first down. Drake. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1.
2nd and 1 yard.
To the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
First down, Arizona.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a 1st and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. That's complete right around the 8. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. It's a good gain of 11. Sets him up first and goal.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch him drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Tight end carry, and he will get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. A 3-yard touchdown run, and the Cardinals are an extra point away from taking the lead. And with that, his guys take the lead here by a point.
Makes the score Cardinals 49, Packers 48. Zane Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. He had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
The Packers take over first and 10.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock. So tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And they will finally run him down, but not until he brings this one all the way back down inside the 10-yard line.
And that one, it's going to hurt big time. You're in the 2-minute drill trying to get your guys down the field, and it's looking like they're going to go up just short, as this is definitely not his best throw. And it'll wind up being intercepted.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal.
Get off the field.
And he's across for the touchdown. And in the final minute, that should just about seal it.
And that touchdown puts him up 7. But now's when the fun begins, partner, because if you go ahead and kick the extra point, it's still a one-possession game. Go for 2, you might put it out of reach.
Yeah, a little decision to be made. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a 2-point conversion to tie it. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. They're down here in a 1-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of.
A big seam, and he might go all the way. And he's into the end zone. No flags. It's a touchdown. And now a 2-point conversion. And we'll be tied here in the final minute.
Do they have one big call left? Here we go.
So here we go. The Packers will line up to go for 2. Now Rodgers, and they don't get it. They tried for the 2-point conversion there, but unsuccessful.
Cardinals 56, Packers 54. Mason Crosby.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And 3 timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point, as this one is all but over.
If they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show. We got a plane to catch.
The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this fourth quarter. They stay on the ground with Drake. And he'll be taken down right around the 27. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. On third and short, Drake. A first down and more for Drake. He's at the 40, 20, 10, and he's across for the late touchdown. And in the final seconds, that one should just about put a capper on this game. You talk about the dominating rushing performances that you and I have seen together. This has got to be right up there. His fourth touchdown run of the game and another long one to boot.
And I don't need to ask for a witness because you're right here with me. We are watching this, and we're watching such a performance that is demoralizing for anyone on defense. You know, it starts out coaches screaming, tackle him, get him. And after that last touchdown, I bet it's pure silence on that side of the ball.
The lane opens here. He's past the 30. Room to run at the 50. Still going inside the 30. And they are not going to catch him. He's in. Problem for them, they needed that score with a little more time left on the clock. I think just too little too late now.
I would agree with that. We're programmed never to say never. But in this case, we're asking a lot for them to even think they have a chance.
So this likely just to get the final score a bit closer given the time remaining, but they'll have a go for two here. One final try for Rodgers. We've seen this before. And it is caught. They got the 2 points, and with it, they've taken the lead. So with just a few ticks left, they need a miracle. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. The risk-reward of the onside kick. When you don't get it, the risk comes out to play, and here they gave up great field position.
And that's the key to everything because you're trying your best to press advantages when you have them, and field position leads you to that type of play calling, and whether you want a blitz or whether you want to throw the ball deep, those types of things, now that they've given up that type of field position, the advantage is switched to their opponent.
Charles, this one's going to be hard to digest. You take the lead into the fourth quarter, lose that lead. Maybe they felt like they let this one slip away a little bit.
They will definitely feel like that because when you have a lead in the fourth quarter, all you talk about doing is finishing and closing a game out. But when you flip it over, how about that? Making the comeback and then finishing the game, sealing it on defense, they will feel jubilant in their locker room.
So that